House Ways and Means Committee staff members distributed copies of amendments to the Republican tax reform bill to committee members on Wednesday. J. Scott Applewhite, Associated Press, Washington. Republicans charged ahead with their plans to overhaul the tax code on Thursday, as the Senate prepared to unveil its own proposal and a House panel closed in on approving its legislation. The expected approval by the House panel, the Ways and Means Committee, would pave the way for a vote on the bill by the chamber next week. But Republicans were still wrestling with a critical math problem on Thursday, particularly in the House, where lawmakers now have a sizable revenue hole to fill. To avoid a Democratic filibuster, the tax legislation can add no more than $1.5 trillion to federal budget deficit over a decade, and the House bill appeared to exceed that limit because it cut federal revenue by about $1.57 trillion over a decade, according to an estimate earlier this week by the Joint Committee on Taxation. Keeping the cost of the tax bill to $1.5 trillion will be a tough task for lawmakers, who are trying to reduce both corporate and individual taxes. The cut to the corporate tax rate alone is estimated to cost nearly that amount over a decade. Republicans are already under fire from fellow lawmakers and industry groups for scaling back valuable tax benefits for individuals, including deductions for state and local taxes, student loan interest, and medical expenses. Representative Kevin Brady, Republican of Texas and the chairman of the Ways and Means Committee, was expected to unveil an amendment to the tax bill at some point on Thursday, though it was unclear what revisions might be in the offing. Mr. Brady did clarify on Thursday that the bill would not allow so-called pass-through businesses to deduct their state and local income taxes. Some lawmakers had raised concerns that the Republican bill appeared to allow pass-through businesses, which are currently taxed at the individual rates of their owners, to continue claiming the deduction for state and local income taxes, even though such a benefit would no longer be allowed for individual taxpayers, who would be limited to deducting $10,000 in property taxes. In a letter to Representative Earl Blumenauer, an Oregon Democrat, Mr. Brady said that pass-through businesses would still be able to deduct sales and certain property taxes, but said that state and local income taxes paid by an individual owner of such a business would not be deductible on the individual's tax return. One possible change to the House proposal is to repeal the Affordable Care Act's requirement that most people have health coverage or pay a penalty. Getting rid of that requirement, known as the individual mandate, would allow Republicans to take a step toward dismantling the health law. Significantly, it would also free up money to help pay for tax cuts. The Congressional Budget Office said on Wednesday that repealing the individual mandate starting in 2019 would reduce federal budget deficits by $338 billion in the coming decade. As a result of repealing the mandate, the number of people with health coverage would decrease by 13 million by 2027, according to the Budget Office. As a result, the federal government would spend less on subsists for health coverage. Also on Thursday, the Senate Finance Committee was expected to unveil its own tax proposal, a key step as lawmakers try to move quickly enough to be able to send a bill to President Trump by the end of the year. Republican senators, who will be briefed on the final plan on Thursday, were weighing the delicate trade-offs of potentially repealing the Affordable Care Act's mandate and the possibility of repealing the estate tax. "I'm for doing that, if it helps us get to the requisite number of votes," said Senator John Cornyn, a Texas Republican who sits the Finance Committee. "If it hurts us getting to the requisite number of votes, then I don't think it should be included." Senator Jeff Flake, Republican of Arizona, said that he would also be happy to repeal the mandate, but that he was wary of injecting the politics of health care into the tax debate. "If we can do it, fine, if it doesn't imperil the rest," Mr. Flake said. Senator Lindsey Graham, Republican of South Carolina, said that while he favored repealing the estate tax, he was reluctant to do so if it meant that the adoption tax credit, which he also supports, had to be eliminated. He is wise supportive of repealing the health law's mandate and said that the employer mandate should also be on the table. Mr. Graham said that for Republicans, the stakes of overhauling the tax code could not be higher. "The party fractures. Most incumbents in 2018 will get a severe primary challenge. All of them will probably lose. The base will fracture. The financial contributions will stop," Mr. Graham said of the consequences if the tax effort collapsed. "Other than that, it will be fine."